No mules. Farn lived right next to a waterhole on a deep, wide river in South Africa. He lived in a kraal with his mother and father and his mule called Golo. Golo was a pure white mule, except for his nose, which was pink. Every morning after breakfast, Farn, Dad and Golo set off to work in the forest. As they went along, Farn played on his flute, which he had made for himself from a reed. When he was going to work, he liked to play the woodman's favourite song. It went like this.
The tree is tall, so chop it down. I hope it will fall on the boss's crown.
All the woodmen liked this song because the tune had a jolly rhythm, and even the boss had to smile when he heard it. Farn's father was a woodcutter. Every day, he and the other woodcutters had to chop down the tall trees that the boss had marked out. Then Golo was harnessed to the great trunks, and Farn had to lead him to the road where a truck was waiting to carry the logs away, to the sawmill on Pink River. Farn liked it best when he had to drag the logs downhill to the waiting trucks. It was fun rushing down the hill. But sometimes the road was higher up the hillside, and then Farn and Golo had to heave and struggle to pull the heavy trunks up to it. When they got to the road, the men took the harness off Golo and began to load the trunks onto the trucks. They chanted and sang, and Farn, when he had got his breath back, joined in on his flute.
The bus is in a hurry, so get a move on. Do not linger, load the timber. The bus is in a hurry, so get a move on. Yeah, the bus is in a hurry, so get a move on.
Then the boss climbed into the driving seat, and the truck roared off to Pink River. The cutting, the dragging, and the loading went on all day. But after the last truck had gone roaring off to the sawmill, Farn and Golo went down to the river to wash. While he swam in the clear water, Farn thought with longing of the day when he would be old enough to go to Pink River. At last, the great day arrived. Farn's father and mother had decided to make a trip to Pink River and said that Farn could go too.
Farn jumped up and down with excitement. Then he remembered that Golo had never seen Pink River either,
and he asked Dad whether he could take him too. Dad agreed, and they set off. Mum and Dad rode in front, and Farn and Golo came behind. Arrived at Pink River, Farn was amazed and even a little frightened to see so many people, shops, cars and bicycles, and so was Golo. Dad sent Farn to look around the town while he and Mum went visiting. Farn led Golo along the busy street, staring all round him and especially into all the shop windows. Suddenly, in the window of a general store, he saw a shiny new flute. He knew at once that he wanted that flute more than anything else in the world. He gripped the money he had saved for his trip tightly in his hand and walked boldly into the shop to buy the flute. The shopkeeper was very surprised to see Farn coming into his shop. And before Farn could ask for the flute, he took him by the arm and pointed to a sign hanging outside the door.
"Can't you read what it says?"
he asked.
"It says, no blacks. I only serve whites in here."
And he went back inside his shop. leaving Farn in the street. Farn wanted the flute more than anything in the world, and he tried to think of a way to get it. Then he looked at Golo. "You're white," he said. "Well, except for your pink nose. But I don't think you'll mind that. I'll send you into the shop for it." But Golo was not used to shops, or to being indoors at all, for that matter. He flicked a bottle of sweets over with his tail. His ears got caught up in a coat, and his hooves slithered and clattered on the wooden floor. Women inside the shop screamed, and Golo began to be frightened. But he did remember to drop the money in front of the shopkeeper. Then some men came after Golo and tried to drive him out. They began to shout, and Golo thought he'd better get outside very quickly. He kicked out his hooves and made a dash for the street. Straight through the plate glass window. Farn was astonished to see Golo coming out of the window. Then he saw the flute flying through the air. As he caught it, people came rushing out of the shop trying to catch Golo. Farn saw that the best thing to do was to run away as fast as possible. He leapt onto Golo's back and shouted, "Home!" But the mule did not need to be told. He was already streaking down the street as fast as he could gallop. The shopkeeper ran after them until he was too breathless to run any more. And when Farn saw that he had given up the chase, he slowed Golo down to a walk. Then he took out his flute and blew a few notes. Soon he was playing merrily, and Golo began to trot to the tune of the woodcutter's song.
"The bus is in a hurry, so get a move on. Do not linger, load the timber. The bus is in a hurry, so get a move on. Yeah, the bus is in a hurry, so get a move on."
The shopkeeper returned to his shop. It was in a terrible mess. Slowly he began to clear things up. He put everything back in its place, swept up the broken glass, and soon his shop was looking almost as it did before. Except for one thing. The sign outside the door. He changed that to "No Mules."
Oh,